हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज प्लूरल इफ्यूजन। लेट अस सी द डेफिनेशन। इफ्यूजन, प्लूरल इफ्यूजन इज कलेक्शन ऑफ फ्लूइड इन द प्लूरल स्पेस। नॉर्मल अमाउंट ऑफ प्लूरल फ्लूइड बिटवीन द पेराइटल एंड द विसरल प्लूरा इज अराउंड 5 to 15 ml, and it is there to promote lubrication among the two surfaces so that the two pleural surface moves without friction. Normally pleural effusion is a complication of any disease like heart failure, TB, pneumonia, pulmonary infection, nephrotic syndrome, any type of connective tissue disorder and neoplastic tumors involving lung. Now we will discuss about the pathology behind the pleural effusion. Effusion is either transudate or an exudate. Effusion, pleural effusion is a fluid which is clinically evident. It is measurable. That means large amount of fluid when it is collected in the pleural space, then it is called as effusion. When it is measurable, then it is called as effusion. Then transudate. Transudate, the meaning of transudate is filtrate of plasma that moves across the intact capillary walls. It occurs when formation and reabsorption of pleural fluid are altered, usually seen by imbalances in the hydrostatic pressure or oncotic pressure. So that means excess of fluid will move out and that fluid will enter into the pleural space. That is seen normally in heart failure. That means the pleural the wall is not diseased. There is another type of effusion, that is exudate. Exudate is more common than transudate effusion. Exudate effusion occurs due to inflammation by bacterial products or tumors involving pleural surfaces. That means the pleural surface is diseased. In India, the common cause of pleural effusion is pulmonary tuberculosis if it is not treated. Let us see the signs and symptoms of pleural effusion. If the cause is infectious, then patient will have fever, chills and pleuritic chest pain. And effusion, large effusion will cause dyspnea and orthopnea. There is also production of
the diagnosis cough. Is made by doing a simple chest x-ray. In chest x-ray, it is seen that the trachea is deviated towards the unaffected side, or it is deviated away from the affected side if the pleural effusion is large, because that fluid will push the trachea towards the unaffected side. Then CT scan can be done. Then thoracentesis. Thoracentesis is a diagnostic procedure as well as a therapeutic procedure. In diagnostic test or diagnostic procedure, the pleural fluid is studied for CS, that is culture and sensitivity. Then AFB test for tuberculosis bacilli. Then cytological studies to find out whether any neoplasm or any cancers are involved in pleural effusion or not. Then blood test is done. In that, complete blood count, that means WBC count, is done. Blood chemistry test is also done. Even pleural fluid chemistry is also done. Like pleural fluid is tested for glucose, amylase, lactate, dehydrogenase, protein, amount of protein which is found in the pleural cavity. The management of pleural effusion is thoracentesis. First and foremost is thoracentesis if the effusion is very large.
The purpose of thoracentesis is to relieve dyspnea. Thoracentesis is removing the fluid, pleural fluid, from the pleural space using a needle. Then second is pleurodesis. Pleurodesis is a type of chemical irritant which is inserted into the pleural space with the help of a chest drainage tube, and with in time it will take some time, and then this chemical irritant will act as a seal between the visceral and parietal pleura, so that adhesions will be there between visceral and parietal pleura, and there will be reduction in the total amount of pleural effusion. It is done when other methods measures to reduce the effusion is not so effective. Then antibiotics are used if the cause is infective to treat pleural effusion, like in tuberculosis. Then pleuroperitoneal shunt, it is also to relieve dyspnea or difficulties associated with large amount of fluid which is collected into the pleural space. Pleuroperitoneal shunt, it means there is one tube which is connected from the pleural cavity into the peritoneal cavity, so that excess of fluid is drained out into the peritoneal cavity from the pleural cavity. So it is called as shunting because it is not a normal pathway. It is called as a shunt. So that will also relieve dyspnea to some extent. Then pain management is also an important part in the treatment of pleural effusion. So this is all about pleural effusion. Thank you, students.